When we talked about HER2-positive cancers and the treatment Herceptin, this led to questions related to another drug known as Perjeta. So let's break down how that drug works today. Now, it's also referred to as Pertuzumab, meaning it's a monoclonal antibody or a biologic, and it uses immunotherapy to target cancer cells. And it targets HER2-positive breast cancer cells specifically, and it is very similar to Herceptin, and we'll talk about how they're similar and a little bit different at the end of this video. Additionally, it can be used in combination therapy with Herceptin that has been shown to be more robust and improve clinical outcomes for patients. And lastly, it can also be used as a neoadjuvant, so before one gets surgery, as well as an adjuvant, so after one gets surgery, to help eliminate any remaining cancer cells. Now, HER2 is a receptor on the outside of a cell that is responsible for bringing in growth factors, and that helps to regulate growth of that tissue. However, on HER2-positive cancer cells, there's going to be a lot more receptors. And we use the example of thinking like you have one door to enter a room that limits the number of people that can go in at a time. But if you have many more doors, you can let a lot more people in at once, which is how those receptors work with growth factors, leading to an overgrowth of the cancer. Now, Perjeta is going to directly exert its effects on those HER2 receptors, binding to them and preventing them from bringing in growth factors, just like how Herceptin also binds to HER2 receptors. However, Herceptin is going to specifically bind to subdomain 4, which decreases signaling, whereas Perjeta is going to bind to subdomain 2, which prevents dimerization. So although they're having the effects on the same receptor, they're coming at it from two different angles. So make sure to stay connected to my channel and with Dane Garvin as we continue exploring the oncology field.